Professor David Beckett to be one of the two people to open the exhibition for us. David carries a number of hats and he's an extremely important person for this particular task. He is our Associate Dean with a heavy involvement in teaching within the faculty and has supported the arts for many years in that role. He's an Associate Dean as well of the Melbourne Graduate School of Research, and this being a research project, it's obviously under his banner there. And David is also the Acting Dean for the faculty. So, David, would you like to say a word?
Yeah, I will, Bruce. I'm reminded of Flemington High School last century when I was on the staff, about 100 people in the staff room, and you could easily work out two subgroups. The phys ed folk were easily identifiable. They had Nike and sort of labels like that, and they sat in their part of the staff room. And at the other end of the staff room, there were people dressed in black. And that was you guys. That was the artists, the art teachers. Only 10 of them out of 100, but easily identifiable. And I thought at that stage, this is important identity work going on here for those people. And here, decades later for me, we have around the walls evidence of important identity work. And as Wes has emphasised, it's work in progress and identities in transition. And it's difficult for other disciplines to do what you guys are doing. I'm an English politics teacher at Flemington High School. And I didn't go home and write. I didn't go out and join demonstrations, although I may have. There was a lot going on then. I don't know what the science teachers did or the maths teachers did to show they were passionate about their discipline. At least the phys ed teachers, they looked like they were phys ed teachers, and they were really into being fit, right? And the art teachers looked like they really had a passionate commitment to art. And I've got several pieces on my walls at home that I bought from my colleagues at Flemington High School a couple of decades ago because it was just bloody good art. And they were nice people. So we've got today really a working of the tension between the identity of the teacher and the identity of the artist. Plato says, be careful of artists, you know. This is a subversive activity. And when you look around the walls, you see some of you people are working the tension between subversion and what I'll broadly call compliance. And when you're teaching Year 12 anything, art for example, you'll be set by a curriculum of compliance, a pedagogy of compliance. I've been there and done that for a long time. Right? And yet art by its nature is subversive. Plato was right. No, it's subversive. It's a different way of seeing the world. We need people to live in that point of tension. So I'd say Crossing Boundaries is a great title, but I'd also say the people who are artists in the room at the moment are living in a point of tension. They're not just crossing boundaries. The boundaries leak into each other. It's very fluid work. Identity work is very messy. And the other point I'd say is even perhaps deeper than that. I think what you're doing is instantiating what Donald Shern in the Reflective Practitioner books calls the artistry of practice. And he means that for any profession. And the University of Melbourne's been reshaped to provide master's level entry to the professions. I mean all of them, not just teaching. And you guys are living out what it means to be an artist in the point of the performativity of your work, right? Now, I work with nurses and surgeons and so on, through education. And they say, David, what we're doing around the operating table or around the bedside of rural children is working hard to get the right decision in that crucial clinical moment when there's a hemorrhage. Now, we don't have that kind of drama in our classroom, I hope you don't, right? But we are really about that epistemological point that Shern mentions in the Reflective Practitioner. We are on about the creation of new knowledge at the moment when it's most needed. Now, this is fundamentally different to the way most of us have been brought up in terms of important learning. Important learning is emergent, and it arises in the moment, in the decisionality of the moment. Matisse said this very well. Holy scripture, here we go. He says, suppose I set out to paint an interior. I have before me a cupboard. It gives me a sensation of bright red. I put down a red which satisfies me. Immediately red and the white of the canvas. If I put a green near the red, and if I paint in a yellow floor, there must still be between this green, this yellow, and the white of the canvas a relation that will be satisfactory to me. But these several tones mutually weaken one another. It is necessary, therefore, that the various elements that I use be so balanced that they do not destroy one another. To do this, I must organise my ideas. I am forced to transpose until finally my picture may seem completely challenged. Now, I think that's what the educative purpose of any classroom is. Highly relational, transformational, and judgmental on the way through. It's decisional. But you artists know that. That's what creativity is. I'm not an artist. I'm just an educator. Every educator should do what you do in the practice of their education. So I commend this exhibition. It sparkles with those decisional moments that Matisse draws to our attention. And I invite Marion to join me in opening.
Thank you, David.